Thank you. glad in it. We know that with God, we shall overcome. So come on and let's celebrate God on today. Amen.
Good morning and welcome to the City of Praise Church of Chicago and Greater St. Peter FBH Church. Myself, I have to live with myself, and so I want to be fit for myself to know. I want to be able, as the days go by, always to look myself straight in the eye. I don't want to stand with the setting sun and hate myself for the things I have done. I don't want to keep on the closet shelf a lot of secrets about myself and fool myself as I come and go into thinking no one else will ever know the kind of person I really am. I don't want to dress myself up and stand. I never can hide myself from me. I see what others will never see. I know what others will never know. I never can fool myself. Whatever happens, I want to be self-respecting and conscience-free. Good morning and welcome to the City of Great Church of Chicago and Greater St. Peter.
We shall overcome. Amen. Now please receive Mother Day with our prayer.
Amen. Father God, we come to you on this morning, on this fourth Sunday, the last Sunday in February. Lord, we thank you for another day. We thank you for another day that you have made. Lord, we want to honor you on this day. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we are so glad to be in this service. We thank God for our bishops, our elders, our pastors. We thank God for our nationals. We thank God for all of our saints, all of our clergy. But most of all, we thank God for this day that the young people has set aside to give you worship, to give you praise, and to celebrate in their own way. And we thank God that they are leaders for today and tomorrow. And Lord, we just want to praise you. We want to ask that you send your anointing on our youth today. They love you, Lord, and they are thanking you for what you have done in their lives. And we are expecting great things for our youth on today. Amen. The Black History events for today. Lord, we want to honor you and praise you and lift up your name on high. We ask that you send your anointing. Let your spirit fall on today, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus, we lift you up. The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. Oh God, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. What a mighty God. What a mighty God we serve. It's an honor, Lord. It's a blessing. Oh, Lord, to lift you up, oh, my God. You are our creator. You are our maker. And we just want to praise and thank you, Lord. We thank you for the blood of Jesus that you shed way back on Calvary. And today, Lord, we want to just serve you, Lord, in a mighty way. Oh, God, we ask him that you lift us up, oh, God, on high. And we lift your name on high on today, oh God. Oh God, we are praising you, oh God. We love you, Lord. Oh, we thank you, Lord. Oh God, give us grace. Give us mercy. Give us the joy, oh Lord. The joy of the Lord is our strength on today. Oh God, we just want to thank you for what you have already done. And we know that you're going to be in the service on today. Bless our youth as they go forth, as they lift your name, oh God, and give you the praise, oh God. We thank you, Lord, for them, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus, they are becoming leaders and voices. Oh, my God, we just love them, God, with all of our heart, with all of our soul. In the name of Jesus, as it says in your word, remember thy creator in the days of our youth, oh God. We are thanking you for them, oh God. We are thanking you, Lord. Oh, God, how you created them, oh, God. You bring them forth, oh, God, in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, it's an honor and a pleasure to know, oh, God, that they want to be leaders and to serve you, Lord, and to be somebody. Oh, my God, we thank you. Oh, my God, we praise you, Lord. We praise the Lord on today. Oh, we glorify your name on today. We magnify your name on today. Oh, God, Jesus. Oh, God, Jesus. Be in our service on today, oh, God. Oh, God, you're a great God. You're a mighty God. You sit high and you look low, oh, God. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you and we love you, Lord. Oh, God, as we give you the praises, Lord, as we end this prayer, we ask, oh, God, that you help us, oh, God. In Jesus' name, your name is the greatest. Your name is the sweetest name that we know. Oh, God, in Jesus' name, thank you. Amen.
Good morning, everybody. I'm going to be doing the scripture today. I've decided to read from Acts chapter 10, verses 34 through 35. God does not show favoritism, but accepts from every nation the one who fears him and does what is right. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his word for the edification of our mind, body, and soul. Now I can turn it over to Brother Moses.
Good morning. Good morning, saints. Amen. Brother Landon Moses Hill and Brother Josiah Hill will be doing their rendition of Lift Every Voice and Sing. Praise God as they come in their own way. Amen, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen.
Three, two, three.
Come on. Amen.
till I'm in heaven, sing with the harmony of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the listening skies. Let it be down, loud and rolling sea. Sing a song full of the faith that the dark past has brought. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought. Facing the rising sun of our new day begun, let us march on till victory is won.
Amen. And now you are back in the hands of Sister Yolanda Daniels for our offering.
Amen.
Amen.
Good morning. Welcome to our service on today. And these are the ways to give.
Good morning.
If you're giving to the City of Praise today, Cash App, $FBA Chicago. If you want to give online, www.fbachicagoofficial.org and click on donations. If you want to give to St. Peter on today, Cash App, $St. Peter FBH or Zelle, St. Peter FBH1 at hotmail.com. Or you can mail your payments to 1712 Hovland Court, Evanston, Illinois, 60201. At this time, we will have Hey Black Child by Master Josiah here.
Amen.
Hello, City of Praise, St. Peter's and guests. I will be doing Hey Black Child. Hey, Black Child, do you know who you are, who you really are? Do you know you can be what you want to be if you try to be what you can be? Hey, Black Child, do you know where you are going, where you're really going? Do you know you can learn what you want to learn if you try to learn what you can learn? Hey, Black Child, do you know you are strong? I mean, really strong. Do you know you can do what you want to do if you try to do what you can do? Hey, Black Child, be what you can be. Learn what you must learn. Do what you can do. And tomorrow, your nation will be what you want it to be.
Amen. Thank you. And at this time, I believe it is up. To come up next will be Brother Armand with a poem.
Good morning, Saints. Today I'll be reading to you a poem called History and Liaison of Remembrance of Martin Luther King.
Good morning.
Today is the day we all sing in the honor of Martin Luther King. Whenever people fight to be free, his name is remembered with dignity. When Black people were treated right, he stood strong to lead the fight. He fought with love and not guns or darts. He changed people's minds and their hearts. But some people didn't like his words. He was taken away to a better world. Yet his dreams lives on that we could be free. Will you knock down the walls between me and you and me? Martin Luther King's life did not last, but his dream and his spirit is free at last. Now passing it to Kayla Watson and Brother Wallace, my bad.
Good morning. Today I will be reading a speech by Dr. Martin Luther King. I am not unmindful that some of you have come here out of great trials and tribulations. Some of you come fresh from narrow jails. Some of you have come from areas where your quest for freedom left you battered by storms of persecution and danger. By the winds of police brutality, you have been the veterans of creative suffering. Continue to work with the faith that unearned suffering is redemptive. Go back to Mississippi, go back to Alabama, go back to the South Carolina, go back to Georgia, go back to Louisiana, go back to the slums and ghettos of our northern cities, knowing that somehow this situation can and will be changed. Let us now wallow in a valley of despair. I say to you today, my friend. So even though we face difficulties of today and tomorrow, I still have a dream. It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream. I have a dream that one day in this nation, we will rise and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold this truth to be self-evident that all men are created equal. I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, the sons of farmers and the sons of farmer slave owner will be able to sit down at the table of brotherhood. I have a dream that one day, even the state of Mississippi, a state sweltering with the heat of injustice, sweltering with the heat of oppression, will be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice. I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today. Next will be Caleb Watson.
I have a dream that one day down in Alabama with his vicious racist, with his governor having his lips dripping with the words of interposition and nullification. One day right down in Alabama, little black boys and little black girls will be able to join hands with the white boys and white girls and sisters and brothers. I have a dream today. I have a dream that one day every valley shall be exalted, every hill and mountain shall be made low, the rough places will be made plain, and the crooked places will be made straight. And the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all the flesh shall see it together. This is our hope. This is the faith that I go back to the South with. With this faith, we will be able to hew out the mountains of despair, a stone of hope. With this faith, we will be able to transfer the jangling discords of our nation into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood. With this faith, we will be able to work together, to pray together, to struggle together, to go to jail together, to stand up for the freedom together, knowing that we will be free one day. This will be the day when all of God's children will be able to sing with the new meaning, my country, tis of thee, sweet land of liberty, of thee I sing, land where my father died, land of the pilgrim's pride, from every mountainside, let freedom ring. And if America is to be a great nation, this must become true. And so let freedom ring from the prejudiced hilltops of New Hampshire. Let freedom ring from the mighty mountains of New York. Let freedom ring from the heightening Alleghenies of Pennsylvania. Let freedom ring from the snow-capped Rockies of Colorado. Let freedom ring from the curvaceous slopes of California. But not only that, let freedom ring from the stone tops of Georgia. Let freedom ring from the Lookout Mountains of Tennessee. Let freedom ring from every hill and molehill of Mississippi, from every mountainside, let freedom ring. And when this happens, and when we all allow freedom ring, we will let it ring from every valley and hamlet, from every state and every city. We'll be able to speed up the day that when all God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, and Catholics will be able to join hands and sing in the words of the old Negro spiritual. Free at last, thank God Almighty, we are free at last. And now we will hear from Sister Katie.
So today I'm gonna be doing the inaugural speech by Amanda Gorman, The Hill We Climb. When day comes, we ask ourselves, where can we find light in this never-ending shade? The loss we carry, a sea we must wade. We've braved the belly of the beast. We've learned that quiet isn't always peace. And the norms and notions of what just isn't always justice. And yet the dawn is ours before we knew it. Somehow we do it. Somehow we've weathered and witnessed a nation that isn't broken, but simply unfinished. We the successors of a country and a time where a skinny Black girl descended from slaves and raised by a single mother can dream of becoming president only to find herself reciting for one. And yes, we are far from polished, far from pristine, but that doesn't mean we are striving to form a union that is perfect. We are striving to forge our union with purpose, to compose a country committed to all cultures, colors, characters, and conditions of man. And so we lift our gaze, not to what stands between us, but what stands before us. We close the divide because we know to put our future first, we must first put our differences aside. We lay down our arms so we can reach out arms to one another. We seek harm to none and harmony for all. Let the globe, if anything else, say this is true. That even as we grieved, we grew. That even as we hurt, we hoped. That even as we tired, we tried. That we'll forever be tied together, victorious. Not because we will never again know defeat, but because we will never again sow division. Scripture tells us to envision that everyone shall sit under their own vine and fig tree, and no one shall make them afraid. If we're to live up to our own time, then victory won't lie in the blade. But in all the bridges we've made, that is the promise to glide the hill we climb. If only we dare, it's because being American is more than a pride we inherit. It's the past we step into and how we repair it. We close the divide because we want to put our future first. We must first put our differences aside. We've seen a force that would shatter our nation rather than share it, would destroy our country if it meant delaying democracy. And this effort very nearly succeeded. But while democracy can be periodically delayed, it can never be permanently defeated in its truth. In this faith, we trust, for while we have our eyes on the future, history has its eyes on us. This is the era of just redemption. We feared it in its inception. We did not feel prepared to be the heirs of such a terrifying hour, but within it, we found power to author a new chapter, to offer hope and laughter to ourselves. So while we once asked, how could we possibly prevail over catastrophe? Now we assert, how could catastrophe possibly prevail over us? We will not march back to what was, but move to what shall be a country that is bruised, but hold benevolence, but bold, fierce, and free. We'll not be turned around or interrupted by intimidation, because we know our inaction and inertia will be the inheritance of the next generation. Our blunders become their burdens, but one thing is certain. If we merge mercy with might and might with right, then love becomes our legacy and changes our children's birthright. So let us leave behind a country better than the one we were left. With every breath, my bronze pounded chest, for there was always light if only we're brave enough to see it. We will raise this wounded world into a wondrous one. We will rise from the golden hills of the West. We will rise from the wind swept to the Northeast where our forefathers first realized the revolution. We will rise from the lake rim cities of the middle Western states. We will arise from the sun-baked South. We will rebuild, reconcile, and recover every known nook over our nation. In every corner called our country, our people diverse and beautiful will emerge, battered and beautiful. When day comes, we step out of the shade of flame and unafraid. The new dawn blooms as we free it, for there was always light, if only we're brave enough to see it, if only we're brave enough to be it. Remember, City of Praise, the hill we climb. Now let's turn it over to Sister Allison Watson.
Anybody ask you who I am? I am. If anybody asks you who I am? happens.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Yes, God. Praise the Lord, almost. Everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Yes, God. Praise hallelujah.
The Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord.
Yes, God. Praise yes, God. God. My heart is filled.
God.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Savior. Go ahead and unmute yourself. Come on. Just go ahead and unmute yourself and tell God something.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I'm a child.
God
be the glory.
He's awesome. Awesome.
Excited on this day.
Wonderful.
At the end of our Black History celebration, though Black History is 65 days a year, this month has been set aside. I'm so full and emotional on today for the amazing ministry that our now generation has provided for us on today. Listen, I am so grateful, and my hat go off, amen, to all of our incredible, anointed, on fire, and present young people on today. From the bottom of our hearts, we salute, congratulate, and celebrate you on today. Not that they don't do a wonderful job every fourth Sunday, but today they have really, really shown themselves strong in ministry and in culture. And we are so grateful for what they have provided from the beginning up until now. You all have ministered so sufficiently and gracefully unto us on today. And we say thank you. Come on, City of Praise, St. Peter. Family and friends, let's celebrate them. Put it in our chat. Listen, most of our Facebook chat participants are on the Zoom with us on today. So I need y'all to be on Zoom and go back to Facebook, amen? And let's put some comments in there and tell our young people how much we appreciate them, amen? To our YouTube audience, to our Facebook audience, to our website audience, to all of our audience, our global audience, we say thank God for you. To our presiding prelate of the 3rd Episcopal Diocese, His Grace and Eminence Bishop Alonzo L. Rogers, we praise the Lord for your presence on today. Thanking God for all of our pastors, all of our ministers, our reachers. Let me take care of the church global. To our reachers and to all of our guests, family, and friends who've come to celebrate with us in worship and lift up the name of the Lord, and especially to our youth at large. We are so grateful and excited on today. Amen. We love the Lord. My timeline said 10 minutes, so I'm going to try to do my best. Y'all pray for me. Y'all pray. It's the end of Black History Month. Amen. Last week we talked about standing on the shoulders. And this week we're going to just simply say three words to end this message. And we're going to talk about our rise again. Anybody ready to rise?
Amen.
Anybody ready to rise?
Amen.
Listen.
Amen.
Of joy, who penned the song, "I've been in the storm too long." I know I might be a little older. Y'all might not know about that, but that's one of them hip slapping songs that they used to sing, but it made real sense. I've been in the storm too long. And briefly, for a moment, we want to go to Luke chapter 24 and 1 verse 26. Luke chapter 24 and 1 verse number 6. Amen. And let's talk to the Lord. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we love and we thank you. We appreciate you. There's nobody like you, God. And Lord, we celebrate you for your goodness, your grace, and your mercy. In Jesus' name, Lord, we pray, God, that the word will be effective, that it'll bring empowerment, that it will equip and evangelize the body of believers to greater living. Oh, God, that's what we're all about, evangelism, God. So we pray, God, that this word, God, will come alive on today, that it will strengthen and encourage. In Jesus' name, we pray and we say thank God. Amen. Hallelujah to the name of the Lord. I'll rise again. Somebody go ahead and say it. Put it in the chat. I'll rise again. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, merciful Savior. Pastor Hill, I'm sending you a check right now. Well, I'm sending you a text. Amen. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah, wonderful Savior. Luke 24 and number 6 says, "He is not here, he has risen." I know it's not on Resurrection Sunday yet, but we can just do a pre-preparation. Can we do it? Amen. Remember how he told you while he was still with you in Galilee. Let me say it again. He is not here, he has risen. Remember how he told you while he was still with you in Galilee. Glory to God. I just want to leave for a few moments. I'll rise again. The traditional Palestinian preface for prompt burial continued throughout the first century. In Mark 5 and 3, funeral preparation for Jairus' daughter began right away. And in John 11, Lazarus was buried on the day he died. According to Hebrew study, according to Mishnah, the oldest authoritative post-biblical collection of Jewish oral laws systematically compiled by numerous scholars over a period of about two centuries, a corpse should be buried overnight only on rare occasions. Not being satisfied with the way that Jesus was buried. Come on, Sunday school participants, we read over this a couple of months ago. Not being satisfied, not knowing that it was not done appropriately. Even though he was in a borrowed tomb, the women went to check and prepare for what they thought and expected to be the dead body of our risen Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, going to prepare him for a proper burial. I come to tell somebody, don't worry on today if you've been looked over or even if you've been looked down, if you've been failed or slipped, get back up and get in place because we will rise again. That's all our young people wanted to tell you on today. It might look blemishing right now. It might not look good, might not feel good now, but be encouraged and take heart because we'll rise again. I'm reminded of some songs, some lyrics that came out a couple of years ago, probably over a decade ago. And it simply said, in case you have fallen by the wayside of life, I know you can sing it while I'm saying it, dreams and visions shattered, you are broken inside. But they came and gave us some courage and gave us some hope and said, you don't have to stay in the shape that you're in. I'm about to run out of this room because the potter wants to put you back together again. But you got to come to a mental place. You got to come to a place in your mind, in your heart, and in your spirit that that it won't always be like this. Yes. And the scripture and the song says that God is going to turn and he's going to perfect those things concerning me. I wish I had some songwriters in here or some singers in here to say, help
me. Come on here, Pastor.
Sooner or later, my God, it's going to turn in your favor. Anybody walking in favor instead of fear, anybody understanding and knowing that it might look like doom, but I still got a destiny. And we shall, I believe that's how we open up, Sister Jackie, we shall overcome. And in overcoming, that means I realize that something is out of place. Something went wrong, but just know this, I'm not out yet. I shall rise again. I've come to take a few moments to encourage the survivors who stand on the shoulders of greatness. That was last week. I just want to keep on pushing through here, if you allow me. God is going to restore you right in the presence of what broke you. It don't mean that you got to go back to it, but all will see, my God, the glory and the beauty of the rising of you. Hallelujah. This is not an aha moment. It's the moment we realize that there's still life in me. After I've been broken, after I've been torn, after I've been hurt and humiliated, there's still life in me. And I've got to get up and I've got to rise. I wish somebody say, I'll rise again. Now, I want you to make this personal today. Oh, yes, that thing hurt, but I will rise. Again, Luke 24:6 says, he is not here. That means something changed, something shifted, something happened. Remember how he told you while he was still with you in Galilee. I know this sounds like a resurrection message, and be advised that's exactly what it was intended to do. But at the end of Black History Month, resurrecting the ashes, glory to God, and the anointing to start a new fire. I know you've been saved 67 years. I know you've been speaking in tongues since you learned how to. And I did say since you learned how to. I know you've been going and trying to do all you could. But every now and then, we need some fire. Every now and then, we need some regeneration. Every now and then, we need some pouring of oil. And we've got to understand that in all of it, in all of the suffering, in all of the crying, in all of the despair, in all of the situations, in all of your circumstance, if I keep on living and trusting in God, I shall, I'll rise again. Oh, young people, don't you be disheartened. It might not look the way you want it to look, but you got to encourage yourself in the Lord and know that it ain't gonna always be like this. As long as I keep my mind on God, I'll rise again. We lose, but once we come to the realization, it's not a loss. It was actually God preparing us and saving us. Job 8:7, the friend, the Shuhite, Bildad said, and though your beginning was small, your latter days will be very great. The prophet Haggai in Haggai 2:9 says, the glory of this house will be greater than the glory of the former house, says the Lord Almighty. And in this place, I will grant peace, declares the Lord Almighty. It's talked about the glory of the former house. How did you see the church in its first glory? And how do you see it now? Well, I come to tell you, out of the ashes we shall rise. We'll rise again. Now, I need somebody who understands that the only way out is to go through. I need somebody to understand that the only way out is to go through and to celebrate your new great rising. Anybody ready to get up? Anybody been in the storm too long? I need you to understand that it's time to rise. It might not be what we want it to be, but I got to get up and I've got to rise. I'm reminded of how after we played, carried on and carried out for so long, and a strong encourager will suggest and say, all right, now that's enough. It's time for you to get up now. You've been there long enough. Any strong encouragers on the line today? We see them going through and suffering. We see them, and sometimes we pray, and sometimes we want to take them some water. Sometimes we take them some food. But I want to encourage the strong encourager to go back. Don't let them die in that place. And encourage them. You've been in that place long enough. Now get up and let's go from here. You've got to rise. I've come to be a reminder and to be hope that you've been in that place long enough. It's time to release the struggle and rise. I can't believe, but it's the truth, that some believers love to struggle. And I'm not talking about a struggle that the Lord has given you. I'm not talking about the burden of the Lord. We get comfortable and being miserable. But on today, I want to take you to a whole nother thought, a whole nother mindset, and let you know that you can come out of there. Oftentimes, we're preaching happy messages, and we're not dealing with the mental. We're not dealing with the spiritual. We're not dealing with the day-to-day protocol of life. But listen, come out, come out. Remember, as children, that's what we play. Wherever you
come
are.
Come on, say it, man of God. Say it.
In Jesus' name.
That you don't have to stay that way any longer. You can come out and receive, release, and rise.
Yes, Lord.
I told the church about 2 years ago, and I want you today to tell the National Enquirer, tell the watchman who's looking, my promise is God's plan. The purpose he produced and promised in me, it is to be continued. That's all I want to say, is to be continued. You may look at it today and it might not be what you think it ought to be. God knows it ain't what I think it ought to be, but my promise is to be continued. Hold on, don't throw me away yet. Hold on just for a little while. Give me a break. I'm just in intermission because my promise is to be continued. I want somebody to say to be continued. Don't look at now, but I want you to get ready to see the victory. Don't look at now. You might see the struggle in a storm, but I want to prepare you for a different look. They're closing down one of my favorite stores that look like the Chain of Jewels. Ever since a child, I see and I love to hear their theme song, Take a New Look at an Old Friend. Put your name right there. Don't see me now, but get ready to see me in my promise. From the shoulders to still standing. By the grace of God, come on here, hallelujah, I am still here, and it's by the grace of God. I want you to take heart and hope in his resurrection, because just like Christ, we will rise again. Listen, If you've never been down and out, this won't fit you. I'm so sorry. Come back next week. If you've never wondered while wondering, Lord, how long? This message is not going to be for you. Mm-mm. If you've never had to pray your way out of some circumstances and some seasons and some storms, this ain't for you. You might have to come back to the PM service. We'll find you one. This is not for you. But if you've ever been or felt left or abandoned, this might help you today. If you ever had to trust God when you couldn't trace the next paycheck, and honestly, it seems sometimes you couldn't even find the presence of the Lord, my God, because life got so big and the trouble was so heavy, I come to tell you, this one is for you. This is not for the faint of heart. It's for the faithful reapers of promise, the risers who refuse to die. Tell somebody, I won't die here because I got a promise and I will rise again. Oh, I won't die here. I can't die here because there's a fire left. There's a remnant left. There's some righteousness left. God is still here. Those of holding on to the horns of the altar while a song is brewing up through the storm. Tell somebody, if you will, if you don't mind, if you're not too sanctimonious or too sacred, I'll rise again. Now listen, the young people, they got something that they say, period. But today I want you to put a comma there, because the story will continue. This is not a period moment right here. But this is a comma moment. So hold on to your period till you talk to your friends. But through here today, I want you to put a comma right there. Because this is not my conclusion, but this is just an intermission. I told you I'll be back, and I will rise. I'll rise again. Somebody, if you will, hallelujah. I can hear. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Wonderful Savior. Somebody say, I will rise again. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I want to tell somebody, it did not feel good, but you stood. It was hurtful to know you lost, and sometimes it wasn't your fault. Sickness became a consumer. Mental anguish became a suicidal escape. But through it all, I told you the only way out is through. But through it all, see, listen, you got to be honest with yourself. Some sanctified believers wanted to take their life. You got to be honest with yourself. Some sanctified Holy Ghost filled believers wanted to walk away, felt that it really wasn't worth it. But you got to be honest with yourself. In the mental place where you are, I need to go from natural to a supernatural occurrence, because it cannot stop here, because I am promised. I wish Allison would pop up in the screen and tell you, I'm a promise. I'm a capital P. You got to
come on, help us, Pastor. Help us.
I will rise. I'll rise again. They prepared the dirt and the grave, but by the grace of God, God said, God promised that we'll rise again. Reminded me of the Sunday school lesson when Mary and Martha said, oh, I know that he'll rise, talking about Lazarus. I know he'll rise in the great getting the morning. No. Jesus said, oh, no, this is getting ready to take place today. So that's what I want you to do today, dear heart. I want you to take heart today because it's getting ready to happen now. They said we are the now generation. So it's going to happen now. I want to speak that to you, that God is going to shift now. God is going to move now. Do I got some now believers? Now. This is a now moment. And we will rise again. Listen, we've dealt with some real life deadly situations. Naturally, emotionally, spiritually, physically, and then had the audacity to go through COVID. And now a new strand, I don't even know if it still got a name or not, but I want to tell somebody to go get your mind back. Let's heal and rise. Notice the order of operation. Go get your mind back, because if you heal without your mind being in the mix, it's going to lead you to the same result. But go get your mind back. pull that mind back in. Get out of your will and out of your way and back to the things of God. Go get your mind back so we can rise and heal. We are, hallelujah, the people from Egypt to today, glory to his name, who understood and understand through physical and mental slavery, racism and being blackballed, held back and held up from others and including ourselves. Don't you count them out, because we do it to ourselves as well. Not in the world, but in the church. I want to talk to you like Brother Josiah did. Instead of, hey, black child, I want to say, hey, you survivor. Oh, bless your heart. I'm so proud of your heart. It's been beat, it's been battered and broken, but the heart remains with a beat. It's been scarred and scared, but it survived and still standing. And now it's time to put a bandage on it. And now it's time to let the healing go so we will rise. Somebody shall arise again. Listen, in the scripture, they didn't believe that he got up. They didn't think that you would either. But look at you on this line today. Look at you viewing and hearing exactly what the youth ministry is presenting. He showed them the scars in his hands and in his feet. Glory to God. He ate and talked with them. And then they remembered. Then they got it. I want you to know they'll get it later on. They might not understand today. And it's really not for everybody to understand. But you hold on to your confession. You hold on to your testimony and tell somebody, see what the Lord has done. They couldn't believe it. He got up and showed himself to them and stayed with them and encouraged them and taught them, told them to remain until the promise come. That's what he told them then. But I want you to know that the promise is here. You can relax tonight. You can get some peace because the promise is here. That spirit was lifted. And I hope that this message is doing that for you on today. Their countenance was changed. Their lives never the same. When they knew, accepted, and realized that they had to rise. They had to rise. He's already proven what he said. It reminds me of the song, What More Can He Do? He laid the foundation and opened up the way. What more can he do? I want to let you know today, you got some options. You can sit and lick the wounds like Sally in a corner and cry, or you can rise and win. Those are only options I'm giving you. You can sit there in misery. You can sit there with it, or you can heal.
Yes,
and you can rise and you can win.
Let me
identify some things. Depression. I need some sanctified believers now. Somebody shout, we win. My God. Trauma.
We win.
Go ahead. Glory. Let me do it. Depression, we win. Trauma, we win. Mental anguish, we win. Suicidal thoughts, we win. Feeling unworthy, we win. Rape and molestation, we win. From the grips of the oppressor, we win. Your mama's misery, we win. Daddy's devastation, we win. The childhood drama, we win. Rejection to relief. Today we win and we shall rise.
Yes.
Getting the necessary support spiritually and mentally. Did you hear that? Getting the necessary support spiritually and mentally to supernaturally to deal with it, from the ashes from it, and to live through it. But know that you are not alone. You are not alone.
That's Pastor. Come on.
I am here with you. That's Pastor Shelton. It's not about the crowd, but it's about you being complete. So we introduce to you today, hot off the presses, ain't nobody never ever heard of it. Our newest form of ministry called Family Life. Well, we're going to be dealing with family, marriage, youth, singles, and your health. Somebody say family life. Because throughout history, and it must remain, the community and family advocate for raising and rising of all mankind. I got to go because I'm boring you. The late Dr. Maya Angelou wrote, out of the huts of history shame, I rise. Up from a past that's rooted in pain, I rise. I'm a black ocean leaping and wide. Wailing and swelling, I bear in the tide. I'm sure you know it, you heard it. Leaving behind, that was the decision. The nights of terror and fear, I rise. Into a daybreak that is so wondrously clear, I rise. Bringing the gifts that my ancestors gave. I am the dream and the hope of the slave. My God, I told you last week we were standing on the shoulders of greatness. She said, I'm the dream. My God, somebody's been waiting for you. I'm the dream. Somebody's depending on you. I'm the dream. Somebody is waiting for you to get up and rise. Tell your mind. Get it in your heart so it will react through your body and your actions. We got some more fire and life left in us. It was left to us. The word says greater works means greater opportunity, the same authority, greater place, the same power. Let's try God and rise. We've been down before. You know what it is to be down. That's all half of us got to talk about is being down. But I want to change the conversation today. And after this, I'm going to talk about my rising. It keeps us close to the ground when we're down. But understand that's where the seed is. But like the seed, we shall sprout and we shall rise again. If we're Team Jesus, that's what you said, ain't it? And if we're better together, that's what I added, ain't it? I want you to say less. That's another young word. Say less. Say less. Say less, but we've got to do more. Make sure we, not an individual, but make sure your sisters and your brothers, make sure the young people, make sure the community, make sure the city, make sure the world can't fall or fail, but that we finish. Somebody say finish strong. I come to tell you, I will not kill you, but I will keep you lifted. I will not come to distract you, but I will come to help you get to your destiny. I will not harm you, but I will offer my heart and my hope and my help. Proverbs 27 and 17 talks about it real good. It says, as iron sharpens iron. So one person sharpens another. Reminded me of lyrics from one of Chicago's famed international choir who sung the song, if by chance you see me walking with my head bowed down, if by chance I do not greet you with an outstretched hand. This is too old for y'all. I'm so sorry. I'll tell you about it in a minute. If by chance you see me always straddled by a frown, don't be angry, but pray for me. So I want to offer that information to you today. That was by Cosmopolitan Church of Prayer. Hallelujah. In the late 70s or early 80s, they simply wanted you to know, if I'm going through something, don't look at me strange. Don't count me out, because I'll be back and I'll rise again. Tell somebody, just pray for me. Just pray for me. Let me give you the whole thing out of here. Matthew 28 and 20 says, teach them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you, and lo, I am with you always, even until the end of the earth. I just took it and paraphrased it this way. Even when I get to rock bottom, he said, lo, hallelujah, and the high, glory to God. And from the low place, he'll be there. Isaiah 59 and 19 says, so shall they fear the name of the Lord from the west, and his glory from the rising of the sun. When the enemy comes in like a flood, the spirit of the Lord, it didn't say my power or my might, it said the spirit of the Lord will lift up a standard against him. 1 Peter 5 and 10 says, and the grace of God, who has called you unto his eternal glory in Christ, after you have suffered a little while. Anybody tired of suffering? But I come to tell you, it's a suffering way. It's a pressing.
Come on, help yourself, sir.
But oh my God, on today, God gave us and courage through Christ. He says, and after you have suffered a little while, so I come to tell you, Sally, to get up and dry your weeping eyes. After you have suffered a little while, I know your pillow was probably wet with tears on last night, but you had the audacity and enough strength and power to get up on today. And since you got up on today, I come to tell you the best is still yet to come. I know it may have looked dark or looked dismal, but you survived the worst of time. And the psalmist said God was right there on your side. It reminds me of the sea poem when a man was talking about walking along the sea and he was walking with Christ. And all of a sudden, he only saw two sets of footprints and he thought that they were his. But Christ had to remind him, no, 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 no. That's when I picked you up. That's when I carried you through. I want somebody to know that God is not through concerning you. He'll pick you up and he'll help you to rise. He'll hold your hand. He'll ease the pain so you can smile again. Somebody say, I'll rise again. Don't count me out because the people who do, they just couldn't count because I will rise again. Somebody say, I'll rise up.
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 This is not my end, but this is just the dawning of a brand new beginning. How many new beginnings do I get? As many as I can be afforded. As many as the Lord would allow. I'll rise up. Happy Black History Month. Happy Black History Month to you. Let's rise. Let's rise to the occasion. Let's rise. Oh, I told you when I started, I've been in a storm too long, but I've never seen a storm that wouldn't run out of rain. Your storm will pass. But even in the midst of a storm, you sanctified believers, don't lose your praise. Learn how to dance in the rain. Ah, somebody say, I'll rise up.
I'll rise up.
I'll rise up. I've learned to dance in the rain. I've learned to smile while suffering. Because when God get through with me, I shall come forth. I'm not waiting on man's opportunity, but when God get through with me, Pastor said, I've learned. Oh, I've learned. And that's the song, Pastor. I've learned how to live holy. I've learned how to live right. I've learned how to suffer. For if I suffer, I will reign. I'll gain eternal life. Dance in the rain. One of my favorite favorite movies is A Family That Prays. I believe it's A Family That Prays. And at the end, they played the song, I Hope You Dance. Now, when they played that song, they was playing it for whatever reason. But I took it and I put it to a whole nother beat and I just started dancing. After all that you've gone through and you survived, learn how to dance in the rain because the sun will shine again. God bless you on tonight. At this time, receive Pastor Hill for our invitation.
Oh, bless the Lord on today. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank the Lord for that anointed message from our dynamic and just in tune pastor. Come on, glory to God. And we rise. I will rise. Hallelujah. And to the audience out there in Zoom, even in Facebook land, even in YouTube land, even on our computer playback when you go to the website, I will rise. But can you? That's the question. Can you? Do you want to rise? Hallelujah. Out of where you are and what you've been going through. You can rise up out of your situation. You can rise up out of sin and all of your bondages. You can break free. You can break through. Come to Jesus and you can rise. Hallelujah. You don't have to stay in that place no more. Hallelujah. Pastor, you touched the peace and you said Maya Angelou talked about how she rises. And that poem said, and still I'll rise and still I'll rise. Come on. And still, even through the persecution, even through the heartache, even through the pain, I still rise. She said, you may write me down in history with your bitter, twisted lies. You may trot me in the very dirt, but still, like dust, I'll rise. She said, do you want to see broken? Do you want to see my head bowed down and my eyes lowered, shoulders falling down like teardrops, weakened by my soulful cry? No, you even may shoot me with your words, and you may cut me with your eyes. You may kill me with your hatefulness, but come on, still, like air, I will rise. And this that we're talking about, this risen state, this resurrection state, come from a life with Jesus Christ. If you don't know him, I pray you want to get to know him. You don't have to stay down there. He's saying, enter in, welcome, come on in, rise. Hallelujah, Jesus. Rise up. You feel that burning. You feel that pulling. If you are on all of those other platforms, just put it in the chat. We will welcome you in to God's kingdom. Amen. It's not me who's talking to you. It's the spirit of the risen. It is the spirit of the risen one. His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus. You matter to him. He doesn't want to see you die in that place. Rise like the day. Rise. As we say to you, welcome. Come on in. This is your day. This is your time to rise. Hey, listen, y'all. Y'all know I'm going through, but guess what? I know I still rise.
Hallelujah.
I still rise. Hallelujah. I'm rising right now.
Hallelujah.
I am risen.
Yes, God.
Because the prayers of the righteous, the fervent and effectual prayer of the rising, it proveth much. It demonstrates much. It rises us up in the name of Jesus. We will rise. But can you rise? If you don't feel that you are rising, come on in on this side with the risen one. It's available to you. This is your day. This is your time. I'm going to wait right there, Pastor, because there is one. Let me know when that one says that they ready to rise with Christ. You better put it in there. Still you rise. Just like the ashes. Just like the air, you rise. Just put that, I'm ready to rise. We know what it means. There it is. We still rise. I'm ready to rise. I'm ready to rise. I'm ready to rise out of the old and go into the new. I'm ready to rise up out of my situation and my condition. I'm ready to rise up out of this state of mind. I'm ready to rise up and truly be a part of the body of Christ. I'm tired of phony kicking it. I'm tired of playing games with this lane. I'm ready to rise. I'm ready to walk into my calling. I'm ready to be God's promise. I'm ready to rise into my purpose. I am rising. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father God. I know they have come. I know they have said it. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. I don't even got to say if there is none, because there is one. Mm-hmm. There it is. Uh-huh. There it is. I know there's one. Amen. And they have risen. We thank God for you who have come, and we're going to reach out to you. Amen. So that you can stay connected and that you will rise with us as we go on to see what Jesus has for you in the end. At this time, Sister Peppers, I believe as she come in her own way to do our announcements. Praise God.
Sister Jackie.
Sister Jackie. Amen. Sister Jackie.
Amen. Good morning, everyone. Today is Sunday, February 28th, 2021, and these are your ministry reminders and updates for St. Peter Faith Tabernacle and the City of Praise Church of Chicago. February is a wonderful month to celebrate our incredible history and each other. Today, we celebrate Mother Glendine Lane, for her birthday today, February 28th. Let's celebrate. Let us march on until victory is won. Saturday, March 6th, join our Sunday school department for our annual 12 Keys Word Revival. 12 speakers with 12 words for 5 minutes. This will take place on our Zoom platform, 344-323-1145 at 2 p.m. Central Standard Time. To become a speaker or for more information, please see our Sunday school department. Saturday, March 6th, join our district president and the senior mission departments for an evening of praise at 7 p.m. on Zoom, same number, 344-323-1145. In preparation for the live worship, we have 2 days, one per campus, to clean and spruce up. The City of Praise will be Saturday, March 20th, from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m., and Greater St. Peter will be March 27th, 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. Lunch will be provided on both campuses. And we are back to initiate our first time being back live in the sanctuary on Good Friday night, Friday, April 2nd, 2021. We will be live at the City of Praise Church of Chicago, located 3250 West 60th Street at 6 p.m. Revival and baptism and our first sanctuary worship in over a year. Join us live for Resurrection Live at St. Peter on Resurrection Sunday, Sunday, April 4th, 2021 at 9 a.m. as we celebrate the power of the resurrection at 1712 Hovland Court in Evanston, Illinois, 60201. Candy bag materials are needed and should be brought to the church no later than Good Friday, or you can cash app a donation to be purchased. In the memo, please add candy. We are collecting clothes again for yet another fun drive. We are accepting clothes now until Sunday, May 16th, 2021. Your support is greatly appreciated as we create community for our campuses. Here are some events coming up for us that you should be aware of. If you desire to help plan and execute any of these items, please sign up with the pastor's office. St. Peter's Church Anniversary, April 24th. Our Pre-Mother's Day Mission Tea, May 8th. And the City of Praise Church Anniversary, June 5th. Please remember to stay connected with us on YouTube, Twitter at FBH Chicago, Facebook, FBH Chicago Official, and our website, www.fbhchicagoofficial.org. Are you tipping, tripping, or sewing? Luke 6 and 38 says, give, and it will be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, will be put into your lap. For with the measure you use it, will be measured back to you. Remember that we are a sewing ministry. To donate to the City of Praise, you can give by Cash App at $FBH Chicago, or you can give via our website, www.fbhchicagoofficial.org, and click donation. Or if you would like to sew into St. Peter, you can use our Cash App at $St. Peter FBH, or you can give through Zelle with our email address, stpeterfbh1@hotmail.com. You can also mail your donation to 1712 Hovland Court, Evanston, Illinois, 60201. We are here for you. Do you have a prayer request or want to let us know how we're doing? Please visit our website at www.fbhchicagoofficial.org and click Contact Us. You can also call us at 630-641-7340. And the prayer of faith shall save the sick, and the Lord shall raise him up. And if he have committed sins, they shall be forgiven him. We are continuing to pray for those sick and shut in, bereaved, and those who said, remember me. Members in bereavement, none reported. Hallelujah. Members in the hospital, none reported. Praise God. Please let us keep the Hill family in our prayers. Amen. Amen. Let us keep all our precious saints and the world in prayer. This concludes our announcements for Sunday, February 28th, 2021. Please govern yourselves accordingly. Thank you. Please now receive Pastor Roberts.
Praise the Lord, everyone. Let us keep all of our prayer requests and those who are in bereavement in our prayers. We'll continue to pray for our pastor, Pastor Hill, in a loss of her grandmother. And we're not going to call it a loss, amen? We're going to say in the transition of her grandmother, because when you know the Lord, hallelujah, the person who led Pastor Hill to the Lord, hallelujah, is now in the presence of the Lord. And
glory, glory, hallelujah, lived. Hallelujah. In
Jesus' name, we pray now, God, that you will cover Pastor Hill.
Yes, God.
The strength that they need, provide
surpasses
all understanding. And Lord, as we turn mourning into gladness,
yes, God,
we turn the heart into hope. God,
yes,
we
pray now,
God, for the strength like none other.
In the name of Jesus,
as we lead her Aaron and Ur and continue to lift them up during a time like this. We love you and we praise you and we adore you.
In Jesus' name, we Jesus.
Celebrate God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We call
Hallelujah,
on
Jesus. You are so worthy, Jesus.
Thank you.
You're like so worthy, God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So we bless your name, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Oh, wonderful Savior. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you,
Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, God. Oh, wonderful Savior. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
That's the kind of
thing. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, God. Thank you.
Bless the name of our God. Hallelujah. To all of those who had prayer requests spoken and unspoken, we believe God for your
God. Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We have a couple of birthdays this week. Sister Cynthia on Friday. We have Pastor Tracy on last night and Mother Lane on today. Amen. Hallelujah. We are a celebrating church and we celebrate all of our birthdays on this week. Again, to our young people, what a mountain job you have done. On today.
Amen. Wonderful job.
How I was going to get through that message, because I was over here in tears hoping you didn't see me crying.
Yes.
You have made me proud in this ministry grow because of your presence. So our parents, of our young people, thank you for allowing them to participate. And thank you for being them, to push them. Hallelujah. Because that's the only goal that we have, is to push our young people. They are not the church of tomorrow. They are the church of now. This is the now generation for right now people with a right now God. And we thank the Lord for them on today. Listen, we didn't have the opportunity to testify because it's Youth Sunday. So at this time, just for a few moments, we want you to go ahead. I'm going to play a little music if I can find it. If we got some more DJs on the line, go ahead, play it. Amen. But we're getting ready to play a little music so we can shout a little bit.
Hallelujah.
And you can just tell how good the Lord has been. I know you've been holding it. I know you've been holding it. I know you've been waiting on this moment. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. I know you've been waiting for this opportunity to tell God thank you. Amen. Yeah. Again, to our presiding prelate, Bishop Rogers, His Eminence, we're so grateful for your presence, Bishop. Thank you for being here with us on our worship experience. Sister Hicks, that's Sister Hicks is just family. We're just so grateful for Sister Hicks. Amen. Amen. Thank you. Amen. To our DRE, we're so grateful. Amen. We got some guests on this platform on today, and we want to tell our guests, thank you for being here present.
Yes.
Amen. Thank you for being present on today. To all of our guests, amen. We appreciate you. Amen. Yes. Hey there. Hey there. Hey, Market. So good to see you guys.
Yes.
Amen. We greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Which one of them is Tony? Which one of them is Tony?
Great to meet you.
Look at Tony. That's my brother. Good to meet you, man. Good to meet you, man. Pleasure to meet you. Amen. Listen, Tony, just say something real quick.
Something.
Hey, I just want to say,
you know, how you said you was preaching about rise, you know, that's the path that I'm going to be on. And I just really appreciate that God has allowed me to meet you by way of Pastor Tracy. And your church, one of your churches is in Evanston. I'm from Evanston.
Hallelujah.
All right,
come
now.
On,
Peter,
come
Peter.
On. Come on.
Thank you.
All right now.
Okay. How you doing, Pastor? My name is Daryl.
Daryl, it's a pleasure to meet you.
God was the one that led me to Haymarket.
Wow. Come on here.
And I was living in Rogers Park last year. And I'd walked off from my apartment after my wife died. And there was no, I took it real hard. And I did some sinning, and I end up using drugs again. Now I'm back on track.
Hallelujah.
Got my life back together.
Yes, God.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'll be there to visit one Sunday.
Man. Amen.
Amen.
God, that one Sunday will become another Sunday and another Sunday.
Yes, it will.
To fill up the south side and the north side.
Yes, it will.
Saint Peter, get ready. Get ready, greater Saint Peter.
I'm ready for it.
Get ready. Do you hear what I'm saying? Get ready. Pastor, if you're praised, get ready.
He said he's looking for a church home, and this one said he ain't got one neither. Now, come on, Jesus.
It only takes on one step. It only takes one step. We don't talk about this. I look forward to speaking to you real soon. Amen. Praise the name of our God. Hallelujah. Come on, saints, and let's testify.
Hey, yeah.
Good morning, saints. To my pastor, I give you glory and honor, and I honor you on today, God. Thank you for that awesome, awesome message on today. I could not sit back another moment without giving God the glory, letting him know that I appreciate him announcing into my spirit that I will rise again. Oh, Jesus, that was deep for me. Like Pastor said, he was full. I am full. I am so full, but I'm so glad to see each and everybody this morning looking beautiful and handsome. Pastor Hill, I give you my condolences. But I love you all, and you all have a wonderful day. Thank you again, once again, Pastor, for that sermon on today.
Praise the Lord, to God be the glory.
Amen. Good morning, Amen. Everyone.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Good afternoon. Good morning. It's still morning. I'm so sorry. Good morning, everyone. Yeah. Giving honor to God, who is the head of my life, who is my life, to my bishop on the line, to my pastor, to each and every one in their respective places. I just thank God today for another day I've never seen before. I thank him for his grace and his mercy. I thank him for saving me and sanctifying me. I thank him for just everything that what he's done, what he's doing right now, and what he is going to do. I thank Pastor for that wonderful message on today. We all know we can do all things through Christ. We know that we are survivors, but sometimes it just takes a reminder. And that's what that was for me. It was a reminder just to keep on pushing, because it is not over yet. The glory is still yet to come. And I am ever so excited to see what God is going to do in our lives and in my life and in my family's lives and your family's lives. I'm excited because it's only going to get better. Better from here. From now on, it's going to be better. We're going to rise to deeper depths and higher heights, is what they say, only in the Lord. And we are on the right track. So I thank God and I thank Pastor for that message, because we just need that little nudge sometimes to get us going. We were already moving, but we just went up a little higher. We just went up a little higher. So I thank God for every. I thank God for all of you. I pray for you and your families, and please continue to pray for me and mine. Wonderful job, youth. I am so proud of you on today. You guys brought it. Thank you, youth. I love you. God bless you.
Amen. Amen. God bless you, each and every one of you. Briefly, I just want to say amen. I give honor, amen, to my pastor. Amen. Pastor Joseph Roberts. Amen. To Pastor Hill. Amen. God strengthen you in your time of need. Amen. To Pastor Tracy. Amen. To the brethren. Amen. God bless you. And I look forward to you as being a part of the men's division of St. Peter and St. City of Praise to meet with you and greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior. Amen. To our bishop. God bless you. Amen. I'm just so grateful. Amen. To be a part of this worship experience. Amen. To be on the rise. Amen. Amen. It reminded me of a message I preached in the revival. Amen. Take up thy bed and walk. Amen. How the man who had a problem for 38 years, amen, he didn't want, but he said at the troubling of the water, he had nobody to help him in. How many of you know that we don't need nobody? We need to get up off ourselves and get our own strength and rise on that occasion, amen. And I'm just so grateful to see the brothers rising, amen, to know that we can rise. God bless you.
Amen. I honor the Lord on this morning. Amen to my bishop, illustrious bishop, and his family. Thank God for our pastor. Thank you, Pastor Roberts, for such a wonderful word. Amen on today. Thank God for our youth. Thank God for Pastor Hill. You have my condolences. Thank God for our national. Thank God for all of our clergy. We just praise God. Amen for today. We thank God for just being on the line. And I just want to say I thank God for the youth. They did such a magnificent and wonderful job on today. I really enjoyed them. And Pastor, I really enjoy that beautiful, wonderful word, I'll rise again, because truly, I believe that I will rise again. Amen. And I thank God. Amen. Just such great, great job on today. Amen. I thank God, amen, for my life and my health and my strength. I thank God how he just keeps me moving. Amen. I just enjoy the service all day on today. Thank God for this wonderful month. But most of all, I thank God for salvation. I'm saved on today. I'm sanctified. I have the Holy Ghost. Desire your prayers to pray for me. I'll keep pressing on. I'm all in. Amen. I thank him on today because he's just a great God, almighty, mighty and a loving God. Pray for me.
Will there be another witness? We got 2 minutes.
I just want to thank the Lord for another blessed day, a day I never thanked before. Because of his grace and his mercy, I get a blessing. And I just thank the Lord for 51. So I want to thank God for that, because I don't look like what I've been through. So I thank the Lord. Thank you. That I'm right there with you. All of you guys that came out last night, I want to let you guys know I appreciate you guys and I thank you. Listen, I came in and seen my pastor. I could have took off running. I was telling these guys that he's a pastor, but he's down to earth. You know, I'm just grateful to even be here to just, you know, let them know that there is help. There is help. So listen, I don't care what Haymarket say, I'm bringing them up out of here. Do y'all hear me? They're going to have to catch me in the wind. So y'all pray my strength in the Lord. God ain't putting on me. Do y'all hear me? I'm on the men's unit and I'm telling them 3250 West 60th Street. Shh, come on. Do y'all hear me? Hey, God sent some of us here and some of us there. And look, I'm right here. And they coming on to 3250. Pastor, look, you got my back, right? Okay.
We y'all got
strength.
Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Listen, I don't want to miss anybody. Anybody else? It is 10:30. We've done our time today. Amen. So I just want to say to God be the glory for the things that he has done. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for your participation. Amen. God bless you, Sister Hicks. Amen. To everyone on our YouTube platform, thank you for being here. To everyone on our Facebook platform, thank you for being here. To everyone who is live here on Zoom, thank you for being here. Listen, I just want to shout out the amazing Sunday School Department of the City of Praise and St. Peter for providing us with these amazing shirts. Do you see this? Look at what the Sunday school is doing.
Yes. Come on, Sunday.
That's because you sow. Don't forget to sow your seed. I stand on that this is good ground. Listen, this money ain't buying me no Lamborghini. You hear what I'm saying? This ain't putting me in no mansion. This is good ground. And we celebrate the Lord for what God is doing. Look at these shirts. We matter, the now generation. Listen, families, don't forget, I'm already getting some to take your selfies. Take your group pictures, send those to me for our 501c3. Amen. To God be the glory. Pastor is working this thing on today. And I'm gonna try to grab this picture while we're doing this. I'm gonna see if I can do it without being, okay. Look up. There we go. All right, praise the Lord. Amen. Listen, it's been a wonderful day with our young people. Hey, Princess Brooklyn. Next month, we're hoping that Princess Brooklyn will be able to sing us a song, do her dance or whatever. That's right. Whatever Brooklyn want to do, it's going to be on Brooklyn on next month. Amen. We love all of our young people. Thank you again, parents and supervisors, to our YPI supervisors, to our ambassadors for Christ, for all that you do to make sure that the fourth Sunday goes the way that it goes. It takes time, it takes talent, and it takes the treasure. And you provided it all so sufficiently. And we are grateful for it on today. Thank you all so much. So our national DRE, we love and appreciate you. Thank you for giving us inspiration and hope. Amen. We pray that we're doing a good job, amen, on this journey. Okay, so Pastor Hill, do we have anything? Sister Hunter, do we have anything?
Not at this time. Amen.
Amen. Praise the name of our God. Again, we want to tell all of our young people, amazing job. Hopefully we'll have our next outing soon. I've been waiting on it for 2 weeks. Hopefully soon we'll know where we're going. Soon. Hopefully we'll know where we're going. Soon. Look at them smiling stuff. Soon we'll know where we're going. Praise the name of the Lord. They are ready, amen, to partake in something amazing. We want to provide that for them. Amen. Amen. Listen, we're getting ready to come back live. We're almost there. We're almost there, and we need your help. If there's some time you can give to preparing the church even before our set days, let me know, and I promise I'll meet you on either campus. You hear what I'm saying? Let's get prepared for entering back in. Amen. Let's remember our social distancing efforts. If you are wanting to be a part of the music ministry, let us know. Amen. Let Sister Jackie or myself know. We are getting prepared for Good Friday night as well as Resurrection Sunday morning. Amen. It's a good time to be fire baptized. Anybody glad about it today? Anybody glad you saved?
Oh, yes.
Anybody glad you sanctified? Anybody glad you filled with the Holy
Spirit? Yes, God.
Fire? Baptized. This fire is something that water just can't put out, and we're grateful because we shall rise again.
Yes.
And God bless each and every one of you. Sister Day, do we have anything? You got to unmute.
Everything looks good, Pastor.
Amen.
We are on our way.
Praise the name of our Lord. Amen. To our Sunday school, our HYP and YPI departments, we appreciate you and we thank God for you. Amen. Let's talk to the Lord. Father, we thank you for what you have provided for us so sufficiently and generously on today. Thank you, God, for our youth ministry, for our youth leaders, God. We pray, God, that you will continue to pour your spirit, your wisdom, your protection, and your presence over their lives. Lord, help us to be changers of this generation now. In the name of Jesus, Lord, give us the wisdom of what we need in order to provide for them. So God, that the rest of their days, the rest of their lives would be what you've called, appointed, and planned and purposed for their promise. This we pray, God, as we leave this platform, we will not leave your presence, but we will abide with you. We will be strengthened by you, and we will take you with you everywhere we go. We love you, we adore you, we magnify your name. This we pray, we declare in Jesus' name. Amen. I speak great things to you and to your bloodline on this week. I speak promise. I speak promotion. I speak healing. I speak more than enough. I speak healing in the name of Jesus. Receive what God has for you. Everybody have an incredible, have an amazing, have a God-packed day. We love you. We'll see you soon.
Amen.